Welcome to Real-Time Signals Technologies. In this video, we are going to use the Pandas library to read data from a CSV file and also write data out in the CSV format. Okay, so we are going to start here with the CSV file that I have already created named hurricane_data.csv. And you can open this file either in your favorite text editor, or to make it a little bit more readable, you can also open it in Excel. Alright, so there is the file in Excel. So in this CSV file, we have three columns of data containing some information on four hurricanes that have occurred in the west between 1988 and 2005. The first column contains the name of each hurricane. The second column contains the maximum category each hurricane had attended on the Saffir-Simpson hurricane wind scale. And the third column contains the year in which each hurricane occurred. So with this, we can now switch over to the IPython console and enter the commands necessary to read the data into Python. Alright, so here in the IPython console, we are going to import the pandas library and then use the pandas.read_csv method to read data from the hurricane_data.csv file. Okay, and there we are able to verify that we have our data read in an expected with the columns and column data accurately passed into our hurricane_data Python object. And the default separator is comma. So we didn't have to specify the separator or delimiter options in the so-called read_csv function. Alright, so now we are going to look at using the pandas library to write out data in CSV format to our local file system. Now, first we need to create the data that we are going to write out to file. And to do this, we are going to create a data frame containing some hurricane data like what we have just seen in the hurricane_data.csv file. And we are going to create the data frame as a dictionary of series. Now, a series is a pandas data structure that consists of a one-dimensional array which may contain any type of data. And in our case, our first series in this data frame is going to contain string data. And the other two series will contain integer data. Okay, so we have three series, each mapped with a different name: hurricane, max category, and year. And the name that each series is mapped to will serve as a separate column label in our CSV data. So the data included inside each series will serve as the column data for the corresponding mapped name in this dictionary. So we have hurricane Alicia and hurricane Audrey. And hurricane Alicia had a maximum category of 3 on the Saffir-Simpson hurricane wind scale. And it took place in 1983, and hurricane Audrey had a maximum category of 4, and that hurricane took place in 1957. Alright, so now that we have our dictionary created, we can then create our pandas data frame from it. And having done that, we can then verify the data frame's contents for correct data structure and formatting. And okay, so our data looks good. And finally, we will write our data frame out to a new CSV file named dataout.csv in our local file system. And I'll just briefly switch back over to Finder. Let's close this file. And here in Finder, observe that in the Python data files directory here, we only have our CSV file that we read from. And we are going to create our new CSV file in this directory and write the data out to that file. So let's go back to the IPython console, and we are going to use the pandas.dataframe.to_csv method. Okay, so we have made a call to the to_csv function, and we have passed in the file path and file name of the CSV file that we want to create and write the data to. And we also specify the index option to the false so that the row names, well, in this case, each row index number are excluded from the data that is written out to the file. So So with this write operation now complete, let's verify that the file was indeed created and correctly returned to. So I'll go back over to Finder and this output CSV file there. And again, you can open this in your text editor of your choice. There we have our comma separated data as expected. We can also open this file in Excel as well. Just a little bit more readable in this format. And here we see that our data has indeed been written out to our newly created CSV file as desired. So that's it. In this video, we have used the Pandas library to read data from a CSV file and write out to CSV format. So thank you.